48 hours since we left Sydney, and we've now arrived in Bougainville, and things, as is quite normal on these occasions, haven't quite gone according to plan. My bag hasn't arrived, we're not quite sure where it is, we're trying to make some calls to find out about that. We've also found that the president of Bougainville, who was supposed to be on our flight, who we're supposed to be interviewing first thing tomorrow morning, has not arrived. He is not on the island. We're told he'll get here later this week, so now we convene to work out, to follow plan B, once we've worked out what plan B is. Oh yeah, maybe, yeah. Well, this is part of the plan B. I've got to try and find some new socks, new underwear, some new toiletries in order to continue the trip. I don't think this is for me somehow or another. I can't help but thinking I won't wear these when I get back home, but at least it'll save everybody, me, from smelling the van out and putting everybody off along the trip, so we'll carry on and do our shopping. Deodorant. Need that. Right. Well, day two here in Bougainville, and we are now on our way to the mine, which is at the centre of our story. We were supposed to be interviewing the president this morning, but he hasn't turned up, so we are going to reschedule our plans and head down to the mine, find out from the landowners themselves whether they support this growing move in the capital for the mine to reopen. Well, we're on our way to Arawa, the former capital here in Bougainville. We'll be staying here overnight and then moving up to the Panguna mine in the morning. It's a bone-rattling four-hour journey down to Arawa. And we're expecting to find somewhere a little bit different than normal. And that's because Hollywood is in town. Hugh Laurie filming The Adventures of Mr. Pip, all about the last white man in Bougainville during the crisis. Well, it's taken us about 6 hours and we've finally arrived here in Arawa. This is a former mining town. A lot of the buildings round about here are where the miners used to stay, and we're staying in one for the next two nights. This is our home. Home from home. Looks all right, actually. I'm going to get in at the back, so you guys get in first. The problem for the government here is, though they may be attempting to negotiate the reopening of the mine, the reality is they don't even control the area around it. The mine's effectively a no-go zone. There is a road leading to it, and it is blocked off by armed rebels with the assistance of former members of the Bougainville Revolutionary Army. We're about to attempt to negotiate our way through. Put the camera down.
I have a
You can film that.
Okay, he's gonna come with us.
It's Peg, huh?
Hello.
Who are you? Who are you, gentlemen?
Okay. We're from SBS TV SBS. Australia.
Spies for the Australia?
No. The opposite.
The opposite?
Yeah. We're here to try and tell your story. Well, that was a good get. We were hoping to get one of the landowners that was on that original class action, and as soon as we've come up here, we bumped into one of them, and he's keen to speak, so that's a bit of progress, because we were a bit worried about just how amenable people would be. But we've obviously got the right people here with us, because everybody here seems to know the people that have escorted us, and so far we haven't even had to pay any money to get up here. We might have to pay money later, but we haven't had to bribe our way up here, which is quite good. So this is it, the Panguna mine, 2 kilometres wide, 0.5 kilometre deep. This was once the largest copper mine in the world. As we know, it caused a fair deal of problems. Well, that was a bit disappointing, not to say disconcerting. When we went through the roadblock this morning, they said that we would need to pay $60 to come back out. When we got down this evening, that figure had risen to $500. We said we couldn't afford to pay that, and a bit of an argument ensued. But thanks to the efforts of Geraldine and the guys here, we managed to negotiate that down to $100. Well, yet again, Geraldine saves the day. We were 50 kilos over when we tried to check in here in Buca this morning, but she knew people as always and managed to persuade them not to charge us. It's time for us to wrap up our trip now and head back to Moresby, and the only thing we've got to do is thank the best fixer that I've ever had on a trip.
Really?
Yeah, you knew everybody, you smoothed our way, you saved us money. Yeah, we would have been in a pretty bad situation without you.
My pleasure.